So what are CFD, derivative products, trading over the counters? You see, all these things are pretty technical, but what you need to understand is you will participate in the price movement. And please bear in mind, you do not own the underlying asset, meaning you don't have the voting rights. Okay, you will not be invited for the AGM unless you own the cash equities. So it's a contractual agreement between you as an investor or as a trader with the broker. Okay, so do choose a broker that is regulated by SC. Instruments, any financial instrument, okay, supposedly should be able to carve out as a CFD. But the four most popular will be first equity CFD. DMA, okay, DMA. It's direct market access, meaning there is no market maker. Okay, there's no middleman. Okay, this order will go straight to exchange and you will be able to participate with the order book of exchange. Okay? If you want transparency, you go for DMA. You want cheaper rates, you go for equity CFD. Oil, gold, silver, copper, soybean. Coffee examples, all these are commodity CFDs. Okay, what is World Energy CFD at the first place? It's running around 20 plus hour for Asia all the way until US market close. And trading World Indices will also allow you to participate some corporate actions. When they give dividends, you receive dividends as well. Of course, proportion dividends. The advantages of CFD. Okay. Leverage, shorting, multi-markets and products, and able to diversify your portfolio. Short selling is one of the key and main features of CFD. So, for example, if you see there's a bearish engulfing, okay, you actually short at this counter at $2 and you drop to 190, you will take back 1,000. So, like I said, it depends. If you're using CFD, imagine your capital, though the margin with the contract value is 20,000, you only need 10% of the whole contract value, which is 2,000, and your return is 1,000. So that is the rosy part. Please bear that in mind. Okay, it can be good, it can be bad. So leverage, what I always told my client, my team members, is a double-edged sword. So you really need to know how to master the leverage, how to use the leverage on your right. Side, of course. So what is risk management? I say the words I did not mention earlier. Without risk management, okay, it's in fact gambling. Because risk management is the most important aspect about trading, no? But based on my experience, okay, it's also the most overlooked area in trading. So how we manage risk? Okay, to me, the best way is still through financial educations. Know what price to enter, you know exactly what price to take profit, and of course, the what price, the most important price, okay, to stop loss. So placing stop order to remove greed and fear. Okay, so what are the recommended limit orders? It depends. These are the generally more common risk management order. Some call it advanced order types. Some call it risk management orders.